Hi, this is Julieta Yang Orfiano. Welcome to my video. If this is your first time on my channel, please like, share, and subscribe so I can notify you if I have a new video. This is the continuation of part 1 about property, land, and equipment. I discuss in part 1 about the definition and nature of property, land, and equipment. Just click above or the link below this video to watch part 1. In this video, I am going to discuss about the measurement at initial recognition. Measurement at initial recognition. An item of property, plant, and equipment should be recognized as an asset when PAS or IAS number 16 Property, Plant, and Equipment, paragraph number 7, letter A, it is a probable that future economic benefits associated with the asset will flow to the enterprise. And letter B, the cost of the asset to the enterprise can be measured reliably. An item of property, plant, and equipment that qualifies for recognition as an asset shall be measured initially at its cost. The cost of an item of property, plant, and equipment comprises PAS or IAS number 16, property, plant, and equipment, paragraph number 16, letter A, its purchase price, including import duties and non-refundable purchase taxes after deducting trade discounts and rebates. Letter B, any cost directly attributable to bringing the asset to the location and condition necessary for it to be capable of operating in the manner intended by management. Letter C, the initial estimate of the cost of dismantling and removing the item and restoring the site on which it is located. The obligation for which an entity incurs either when the item acquired or as a consequence of having used the item during a particular period for purposes other than to produce inventories during that period. Purchase price shall be viewed in a broader sense and shall not be limited only to the net cash paid to acquire an asset. The purchase price is determined by the mode of acquiring an item of property, plant, and equipment. Thus, the purchase price of an item that is acquired by exchanging another asset is the fair value of the asset given up, unless the fair value of the asset received is more reliably determinable. The purchase price of an item acquired by using the entity's own financial instruments is the fair value of the asset received or the fair value of the financial instruments issued, which is more reliably determinable. The purchase price of an item of property, plant, and equipment is the cash price equivalent at the recognition date. Hence, cash discounts available, whether taken or not, are generally considered as reductions of cost. If payment is deferred beyond normal credit terms, the difference between the cash price equivalent and the total payments is recognized as interest over the period of credit. Examples of directly attributable costs are PAS or IAS number 16, property, plant, and equipment, paragraph number 16, letter A. Cost of employees' benefits arising directly from the construction or acquisition of the item of property, plant, and equipment. Letter B, cost of site preparation. Letter C, initial delivery and handling cost. Letter D, installation and assembly cost. Letter E, cost of testing whether the asset is functioning properly after deducting the net proceeds from selling any items produced while bringing the asset to that location and condition, such as samples produced when testing equipment. And letter F, professional fees. The following are examples of costs that are not costs of an item of property, plant, and equipment. PAS or IAS number 16, property, plant, and equipment, paragraph number 19, letter A. Cost of opening a new facility. Letter B. Cost of introducing a new product or service, including cost of advertising and promotional activities. Letter C. Cost of conducting business in a new location or with a new class of customer, including cost of staff training. And letter D, administration and other general overhead cost. The cost of the assets dismantling, removal, or restoration is required to be estimated at the rate of acquisition. For example, an entity operates an offshore oil field where the licensing agreement requires it to remove the oil rig at the end of production and restore the seabed. Or a company installs an elevator in its building that at the end of 10-year life of the elevator, it will require dismantling. Under IAS number 16, the cost of an item of property, plant, and equipment includes the initial estimate of the cost of dismantling and removing the item and restoring the site on which it is located. The restoration or removal cost is expected to be incurred at the end of the useful life of the asset. Thus, the effect of the time value of money is material. Such cost of removal or restoration, otherwise known as decommissioning costs, shall therefore be discounted at its present value at the date of the acquisition of the asset. At the end of each reporting period, the liability that is recognized for the decommissioning cost is adjusted to its amortized cost. Using an appropriate discount rate using the effective interest method. To illustrate accounting for initial recognition, assume that an item of equipment is purchased by ABC Corporation at a purchase price of 1 million pesos plus 12% value added tax. ABC Corporation is a VAT registered company. Freight costs incurred by the company amounted to 15,000 pesos. The asset is expected to be dismantled at cost of 80,000 pesos at the end of its 5-year useful life. The average borrowing rate of the company at the date of acquisition of the equipment is 10%. The cost of the asset is computed as follows. Purchase price, 1 million pesos. Freight cost, 15,000 pesos. Present value of dismantling cost, 80,000 times 0.62092 is 49,674 pesos. The total cost is 1,064,674 pesos. The value added tax of 120,000 pesos, which is 12% of 1 million pesos, is not included as part of the cost of the asset because it is creditable from the output tax of ABC Corporation since the enterprise is a VAT registered. The acquisition is then recorded as follows. Debit equipment for 1,064,000 674 pesos, debit input VAT for 120,000 pesos, credit cash for 1,135,000 pesos, and credit provision for equipment dismantling for 49,674 pesos. The account provision for equipment dismantling is presented on the statement of financial position as a liability in accordance with IAS number 37 provisions, contingent liabilities and contingent assets, assuming that the company uses a straight line method. The annual depreciation to be taken up is 212,934 pesos. The adjusting entries at the end of the first year are as follows. Debit depreciation expense for 212,934 pesos, and credit accumulated depreciation for 212,934 pesos. 1,064,694 pesos divided by 5 years. Debit accretion expense or interest expense, 4,967 pesos. Credit provision for equipment dismantling, 4,967 pesos. 10% times 49,674 pesos. At the end of the second year, the amount of accretion expense to be taken up is 10% times 49,674 plus 4,967 pesos, or 5,464 pesos. At the end of the 5-year period, the provision for equipment dismantling account would have a balance of 80,000 pesos, such that at the time of disposal of the equipment, the dismantling cost of 80,000 pesos is charged to the provision. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you learned something from this video. I did part 3 and continuation of this video, wherein I discuss in part 3 about specific items of property, plant, and equipment. Just click above or the link below this video to watch part 3. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe on my channel so I can notify you if I have a new video. Once again, this is Julieta Yang Orfiano. See you on my next video.